All right, come over and have a sniff.
I'm being set up.
They for real? All right, go. So, quiet like this. So, please state your name when I tap you on the shoulder.
Greg.
Greg and?
Lisa.
Greg and Lisa. What do you do for a living, Greg and Lisa?
I'm a retired police lieutenant and an attorney.
I see. And you, Lisa?
I'm a retired police officer.
Two cops! Two cops in the show! How did you guys meet? On a stakeout?
No. I walked in and said, you're driving me.
Oh, really? You were her boss?
Yep.
Let me put it to you, Mr. So-called attorney, that this is, in fact, a case of sexual harassment.
You're right.
Is it really?
But she didn't sue me.
Well, but she married you.
I know.
Then I couldn't sue him.
Yeah, and that means she gets more of your stuff that way. So. Do you want to hear my New York cop story? Here's what, like, I was drunk in New York once on a motorcycle. It was a long time ago, statute of limitations is up. And I was on this motorcycle and I come off the motorcycle in an intersection. This New York cop comes over and he goes, give me your driver's license, you're drunk. And I give him my driver's license and it's a British driver's license, right? Because I just come in and open up and it's got a picture of the Queen and a drawing of Hogwarts and some owl feathers and all that. And he looks at it, he goes, what is this? It's a British driver's license. He goes, put it in your pocket, drive away, take care, you'll be all right. He figured that it would be about 3 days' worth of paperwork. Was that you?
No, I pulled over Jill Clayburgh.
Really?
Yeah.
British driver's license?
No license.
No license?
I just said have a nice day.
And that's when you retired. Well, I think everything's worked out rather well. Oh, we're going to send you to a restaurant. What restaurant are we going to send you to?
How about
Sewer? Oh, now, Sewer is the restaurant owned by Lisa Vanderpump, who's the lady is in the... You ever seen the Beverly Hills Housewives thing? She's the lady that owns the restaurant. But here's another story. I ran into her in another restaurant the other day, and apparently she was mad at me. I never told you this. She came over and she was mad at me because I said her name sounded like a penis enlargement device. Like, for example, and she was really mad. She was like, I'm going to make fun of you in my reality show. And I was like, oh, no. But it does sound a bit like, anyway, when you're there, give her my best. Officers of the law, a bit of respect, thank you. Come right back, everyone, come right back. Well done, you guys.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Target. What's your kind of holiday? Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Thanks, everybody. That's great. Very good. Please, knock it off. You'll get your money. Very convincing indeed. They sounded good tonight, didn't they?
Yeah, pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, they sounded like they actually meant it, when, of course, I know you didn't mean it!
They've just been coerced.
They've been coerced. They've been warmed up. They've been, in some way, friendly massaged by the...
Fluffed. They've been fluffed.
Yeah, by the warm-up comedian.
Right. Yeah.
He gets them going. He gets their juices ready.
Gets them all prickly hot.
It's a great day for America, everybody. It is. Not such a great day for New York. Donald Trump says he's considering running for governor of New York next year. I don't know. I think New Yorkers have had enough of wieners running for office, but maybe. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah.
That's right. I called you a wiener. Because he watches the show.
Yeah, right, yeah.
He does. Late at night, he gets home, takes off his hair, relaxes, watches the show.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know that the band Kiss was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Kiss, of course, known for wearing... Yes, congratulations, Kiss. Shall we do our... shall we do our Gene Simmons thing because they've been done?
Yeah,
let's do
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
all right,
yeah,
then. Yeah. Now you do it. Round one to me, you skinny bastard.
How dare you.
Anyway, Kiss, of course, known for wearing the ridiculous outfits and sticking their tongues out. So there's hope for Miley Cyrus, I suppose, then.
Oh, yeah.
You see what I did?
I see what you did.
I mocked a young person for their artistic endeavor. Well done, middle-aged white guy. If I look a little under the weather tonight, and I do, I think, it's because I have a sickness that's sweeping this nation. I've got lottery fever. Thanks, Alfredo Sauce and the Shy Guys, yeah, for that music sting. Hey, how are you tonight, guys? Just a quick recap. The band are so shy, they never come out from behind the curtain. How are you doing tonight, Alfredo?
I'm good. How are you?
Pretty good. Little bit of music?
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Anyway, I've got the... thanks. Thanks for applauding the band, everybody. You're really helping them with their shyness. Yeah, the lottery, the Mega Millions lottery jackpot is now up to $636 million. So after taxes, if you live in California, that is about 34 bucks,
yeah,
I think.
That's right. Yep. Yep.
Don't confuse it, the Mega Millions with the Powerball. They're very different. Powerball is the name I used to dance under. I would crush beer cans with my scrotum. I'm doing it now. No, tonight's Mega Millions is huge. What happens is that once the amount starts getting up there, then it gets bigger faster because everybody wants in. And I admit, I put a dollar in the kitty. I also bought a lottery ticket. Sorry, Tiddles. No, I didn't buy a ticket. I have to admit, I was tempted, though, because I really wanted one of those huge novelty checks. That must be what it's like for Tom Cruise to hold a regular check, don't you think? But the winning Mega Million ticket is worth $636 million. But if you accept a lump sum payout, then it would be $341 million. By the way, lump sum was also the alias I danced under when I was in Chinatown. Yeah, well, I'd do an early show as Powerball, crush the beer cans, then I would drive up to Chinatown and be lump sum. And people would help themselves from my cart.
Oh, yeah. Those were the days.
The truth is, I don't really care for a lottery or any kind of gambling. All you need to know about gambling is you got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, and know when to...
When to run.
When to run, that's right. Kenny Rogers, very wise, although he did gamble himself on a little bit of plastic surgery. You got a picture of Kenny Rogers? There he is. Oh, wait a minute. That's not Kenny Rogers. Come on, the real Kenny Rogers. There you are. Now...
Oh, man.
Man, this audience is like, oh, you've gone too far. Anyway, with all the talk about the lottery, here's what I think people should do. They should stop worrying about getting rich and learn to appreciate the things that they have, like their friends. Look at me. I don't have much money, but I got a gay robot skeleton, and I've got a fake horse. I've got a bandit or too shy to... I should have really bought a ticket for the lottery. They say that money doesn't buy you happiness, but it does buy you cocaine. Which brings you little bursts of excitement before it kills you.
That's true.
I remember when you had to go to Las Vegas or Atlantic City to gamble. Now there's casinos all over the place. I do a lot of shows in the tribal casinos. We've done them together.
Oh,
haven't
yeah.
We?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I do my first show as Powerball, and then I changed and come out as Lump Sum.
Lump sum.
Lump sum, yeah. I like it. Nobody else seems to
yeah,
like
no,
it.
Yeah, no.
You know what I learned at the casinos, though? I learned this, that any poker game can be strip poker if you don't mind being tasered.
Words of wisdom. Words of wisdom.
Words of wisdom, yeah. That's when, you know when to walk away and when to run.
That's
yeah.
right.
That's when you got to run. When they then the security guys run over with the tasers,
yeah.
run. And there's a movement to make Las Vegas more family-friendly, and I support that movement, unless it means getting rid of the hookers and meth. Then I do not support that movement. You don't even have to leave your house to gamble now, do you?
No.
Yeah, you just
no.
gamble. You know, they say 10 million Americans gamble online. To give you an idea how many that is, you take the number of Americans who go online for pornography and subtract about 8 trillion. Do you gamble online?
Oh, yeah, big gambler.
Really? What's your favorite gambly game?
Love Uno, man. Big Uno guy.
Uno? I don't know what Uno is. Is that like Mario?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, it's like Mario.
What's Uno? What do you do?
Uno, man. You got the different colored cards and the draw four. It really, really gets people worked up. It's a great game. We'll play it sometime.
No, we won't. I won't play gambling things. I'm Scottish. I don't get that whole thing. Wait a minute. So I give you the money and you might give me some back, man? No!
How about you give me the money and I'll give you something back?
Yeah. Whoa.
What? No.
What?
What is that even?
Hold on. That's what gets the round of applause.
Man.
The robot admits to being a prostitute, and that's what gets...
Sick people, man.
Sick people. We want to see a robot hoe.
The robot hoe?
Robot hoe,
that's
yeah.
Like a, that's like a pirate call.
No. Robot hoe and lump sum, they used to
that's
dance
right.
together, remember?
Yeah, we were in the band The Fantasy Five. That's what we did together.
You want to take us to the bake?
Yeah, sure.
What do I mean? The break?
Yeah.
Take us to the break, Alfredo, would you? Come on
because
now.
Because you gamble the laws.
That's
you're
right.
The show.
We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back.
Christmas is craft work. Mit Florian und Ralph.
So, Florian, the holidays are almost upon us.
Ja, perhaps Friedrich the Gimp should say a few words about the holidays.
I do not care for the holidays.
Why not?
Because St. Nicholas never brings me what I want.
And what is that?
A robotic penis on wheels that plays dark cabaret music when I'm sexually aroused and also functions as an automobile.
Well, if it's any consolation, I got you a tie.
Welcome back to the show, where tonight we are going crazy,
we're
aren't
control.
We?
Control,
oh,
yeah.
We're out of control. Why?
Why? Because things are happening.
No, really, it's pretty much the same old, really.
Yeah, we're just trying to get people worked
up. Just a creepy foreigner, his gay robot, and he's not a real horse. And, of course, the shyest band in late-night television. Let's hear it for Alfredo
yeah,
Sauce,
yeah.
The Shy Fellas. All right, guys.
The hell, man. Yeah. The hell?
You know, I really give them a big build-up, and then they wouldn't even play their instruments there. Do you notice?
I know.
Like any other band in late night, you do a big build-up, and they start playing. But these guys are like, oh, I don't know. What's wrong, Alfredo? You still feeling?
I'm sorry. I'm nervous about the lottery. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Did you buy a ticket for the lottery?
Yes, a couple of tickets. One for all the members of the band, yes.
Who are all the members of the band again, Alfredo?
Well, we got Nicky D on drum.
Hey, Nicky.
Hey, no.
Yeah. Oh. Hi, Nicky.
Hey, how you doing?
Who else we got over there?
Wait a minute. We also have Terry on bass.
Terry, hi, Terry.
Actually, this is what Terry sounds like. Nicky doesn't sound like that at all.
So what does Nikki sound like?
Hi, this is Nikki on drums.
Hi, Nikki, how are you?
Just slapping those drums, how are you?
All right, I think that's enough.
Yeah, that's fun.
We'll meet the rest of the band. Tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night.
What time is it, Jeff Peterson?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who thought scratchers was something you did to your Powerball.
Play the jingle, would you? All right, this is from Morton in Vancouver, British Columbia. British Columbia.
Columbia.
Columbia. That's how pirates used to say British Columbia, isn't it? Arr, that'd be right. Going up to Canada. Up there, British Columbia, to get some bacon.
Robot ho.
No, that's a different robot.
Sorry, that would be, sorry, man.
That would be robot ho.
Yeah, it would.
That's about as successful a joke as Lump Sum.
Yeah, pretty good, yeah.
Morton in Vancouver says, hey, Craig, can you tell me the origins of the term mailing it in? I can't, but I can sort of show you what mailing it in looks like.
All right. That's it. Yeah, that's good.
Pretty much every night. We don't mail it in. We care about this show.
Oh, man.
Yeah, even the horse is laughing. Yeah. All right, this is from, I don't know where that's from. This is from Roger in Drummond. Did you hear something there? Yeah. It sounded like there's some kind of coyote.
Yeah.
There's a coyote sneaked into the audience.
It's a giggling coyote. That was pretty.
Anyway, Roger in Drummond, Wisconsin says, Craig, I want to apologize for what I said to my friends last night about Secretariat. I'm really sorry, man. It's not me you should be apologizing to. Go ahead. Yeah. I hope you're proud of yourself, you jackass. It's all right, buddy. Come on back up. Come on back up. There you go. Yay. This is from Curtis in Niles, New York. He says, Dear Craig, Jeff, Secretariat, is your band too shy to play at my son's bar mitzvah? I'm paying good money. What do you say, Alfredo? Would you play a bar mitzvah?
We do it. Why not? We need the money. It's well, CBS. They're cheap.
Wow.
Wow, he's doing jokes
he's,
now.
He get worked up.
Yeah, so who's in the band then? There's you, Nikki D on drums.
Nikki D on the drums.
Hi, how are you? How are you?
How are you? And who's on bass?
That's Terry.
Hi, Terry.
Hey, Don.
All right. And is there anyone else?
Yes, we got Joey Turnips on ocarina.
Oh, ocarina. Hey, Joey.
Yeah, how are you?
Can I hear your ocarina?
Thank you.
It's funny, I've never noticed that when the band are actually all playing at the same time.
Yeah, no, it's in there. You got to listen for it.
Yeah, all right. Well, you guys, play a little music and we'll see if the ocarina's
okay.
In there. Go.
1, 2, 3, go!
Oh, I can hear it!
Yeah. Wow.
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 Oh, I felt like I was at the bar right
from
there.
Amazing, yeah.
And this is from Pamela and Quincy in Massachusetts, who says, Craig, how does Jeff play the harmonica without any lips? How do you manage it, Jeff?
Guess where that came from. What the hell? What's wrong with these people?
I don't know. They like dirty music stuff. Yeah. And finally, this is from Sal and Diane, I don't know who this is from. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
How do you do that, actually? Because nothing's moving.
No. It's coming out of my ass, man. You try it.
Okay.
Wow.
I believe in the miracle. Do it again.
Yeah.
All right. Now that I've trained my sphincter to perform musical notes, yeah. Let's see if I can imitate that noise. That what is it called?
Oh, the ocarina.
Yeah, I was going to say a macarena, but that's
macarena. Yeah, all right.
All right, then I'll try and do the ocarina. Are you ready?
Yeah. Oh man, what was going on there? It's
quality entertainment tonight, everybody. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. Tonight is a beautiful actress. She's hosting Project Runway All-Stars, which airs Thursdays on the Lifetime Network. Take a look at this.
Hi, Christopher.
This is Fleur. She's from London. My trend is new vintage Paris soft military.
Do you like the look?
I love it. I have green eyes, so I like wearing kind of army khaki green.
This lace in this color, it's like seaweed that has come out of the swamp.
Thank you.
That's not a compliment.
I didn't take it as a compliment.
The hell?
The hell is going on there? Isn't that, man? Alyssa Milano, everybody. Alyssa Milano. Alyssa.
Hello.
You look, you're very fashion forward this evening. You look very fashion forward.
I'm actually wearing Victor Luna, who is one of the contestants of Project Runway.
Really?
Yes.
Are you allowed to do that? Isn't that showing
favoritism? Yeah, he made it for me. Well, you know, it's already happened, so. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
It's not live?
No, it's not live.
Not like this show?
Not like this show, no. I have to tell you, the last time I did this show, you were kind enough to give me a bunny with glowing eyes.
Yes.
Because it was freezing in here,
yes,
and I was
cold.
Shivering.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Not that it's any warmer tonight.
Keeps my nipples barricaded.
And so I took it home.
Yes.
And I got hate tweets.
From your
fans, your crazy
fans.
No, apparently I didn't know the bunny had a name.
Sid.
Sid.
Yeah, yeah. Sid is fine. I gave you a fake Sid. Sid is fine. He's right here.
Oh, see?
Yeah, watch. See? He's fine. Look, everyone at home, everyone will be fine. Watch. What's your problem? Everything's fine.
Oh.
There you go.
Well, I was gonna.
Please don't put me back! Don't put me back! Yes, you have to go back. No, please.
I was gonna bring him back to you tonight, but my Australian Shepherd ate him. So.
Wow.
I can't wait. Can't wait to see the tweets.
It's all got a bit grim.
Yeah, it's dark.
What's going on in that Project Runway clip? This looks like there's hate going on between Nina Garcia and that contestant. And you got Mizraki there wearing white pants.
There are some designers that actually call her Mina Garcia.
Oh, get out of here. She's fantastic. She's been
she's
on this.
She's amazing.
She's
amazing.
She's great. And she's been on this
smart
show. She was
and
lovely.
She knows
smells
her stuff.
Delicious.
Does she?
Oh, my goodness.
What's she smell like?
Like a sort of lime chili. I love that. Oh, she's beautiful.
Yeah,
and
she's
also,
beautiful.
You've got Isaac Mizrahi. He can be very tough.
Mama is beautiful.
Yeah,
I called her Mama.
He can be very tough.
He's amazing, though. Such a great spirit. Just like this energy that you can't.
Talented designer, too.
Talented everything. I love
him. Was he wearing white pants in that clip?
Yeah, perhaps. But, you know.
Let me just check my calendar. Labor Day. Gone!
We may have shot that before later.
Oh,
so
I see.
He wasn't breaking any rules.
How are you doing anyway? What's this I've got here? This thing. Is it a movie you're in?
No, that's actually a comic book that I developed.
What the hell? Really?
Yeah!
Oh, that's right. I read it. Well, it's very quick. You just, there it is. That's it.
No. It's a comic book I've been working on for the past, like, year and a half.
Do you follow the comic books? Are you into
all that
world?
You know what? I came up with this idea, and instead of trying to sell it to, like, a television network that would tell me all the reasons why it couldn't be done,
right?
I decided just to take this medium and do a graphic novel.
Well, what is the hacktivist, then?
I became, like, super obsessed with the hacking organization Anonymous. Do you know about?
Yeah, of course.
And then I was interested in how social media was playing a role in, the Arab uprising and protests throughout the world. Mm-hmm. And I thought, like, what if all of Anonymous was actually just one guy?
Oh.
Like, who would that guy need to be?
Jeff Peterson.
Maybe. Perhaps.
What? I mean, he's...
Yep, look at him.
There's your comic book fantasy right there.
Looking good, buddy.
Yeah, you're looking good too, sweetie.
Thank you.
Hey, get a room, you two. Knock it off. So that's what it is.
It's
like one guy. It's like a superhero, but dark and different.
A superhero, but he has no superpowers, except just his brain.
That's like Batman.
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
But don't owe me. Batman doesn't have superpowers.
He does have a suit. And
yeah, I got a suit. Oh, Batman's got a car? I got
Grinding.
A car, bitch. What else?
you can...
let me tell you something.
Okay.
You think you're going to get hate tweets. You wait till that goes out.
You can play the ass harmonica.
I can. In fact, I can play many instruments from my
your
pants.
Ass?
Yes. For example, this.
Wow. I want to try.
Okay, have a go. So, hey, I tell you, I love a girl that enjoys a fart joke.
Oh, okay, so my grandfather used to say there are two types of people in this world. It doesn't matter where you're from, what religion you are. There are people that think that farts are funny and people that don't.
Right.
And that's it. People just fall into those two categories.
Right, I think that's probably true. And I am definitely from the ones that, you know, laugh at. The only thing is, I don't like the actual word itself. I like saying passing gas or trouser cough or something like that. Bottom burp or anything, but I don't like saying the actual... For me, that is the F word.
You know, the baby just started realizing... I have a two-year-old, Milo, which you...
Yeah, I have a...
You have a Milo, too. He just started realizing his farts are funny.
Oh, they are, That took him a while.
It kills me.
Yeah, it's funny.
Yeah, he does it, and he lifts his cheek up, and he'll...
He lifts his cheek up, and he does what?
Like that, exactly. And then he just gets a kick out of himself.
It's funny. And that's what guys
so
get
proud.
That. And that will stay with him his whole life.
Yeah.
Once that's in, it's in. It doesn't go away. It's good.
Do you have big Christmas plans?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I've got two kids.
What are you going
to
do?
Lord, I've got to go to the North Pole.
Right.
What about you? What are you going to do?
We're going to go to our vacation house, which is in the snow, which I'm really excited about.
You have a vacation house?
I do, yeah. Oh,
you got that sweet Project Runway All-Stars.
Yeah, exactly. I have the little check, you know, the souvenir check you were talking about? I don't have that one. But yeah, so we're going to do that. And
do you do skiing?
I don't ski, but because I didn't have much of a childhood. I was working.
Yeah, so. But you can learn later on. I didn't learn to ski until I was 45.
Really?
Yeah. I'm crap at it, but I learned when I was 45.
It's something that I'd like to try to do.
It's great fun.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Just a couple of sticks on your feet and down a hill. My kind of fun.
My boy loves doing things with me, and it could be the most, like, manly thing.
Are we talking to your boy, your kid boy?
My kid boy.
Not your...
Yeah,
your...
not my husband. Okay. He's my man.
Right, I see. He presumably likes doing things with you, too, doesn't he?
Yeah. I got him a Vanderpump for Christmas.
Oh, good, yeah. Yeah. Oh, man. I think Lisa Vanderpump's a bit mad at me. Have you met her?
I've never met her,
She's terribly nice. She was very nice,
I'm
but
sure.
I could tell she was a little bit angry at me.
Well, I mean,
Well, it was just a joke.
It can't be the first time she's heard that,
well,
right?
Well, that's what I thought. I mean, surely, you know, when
Vanderpump.
And she grew up in England, so all the chimney sweeps would be like, oh, your name sounds like a penis and vagina. We're out of time. With that said, we're done.
That's it.
Yeah. Alyssa Milano, everybody. An American icon, an American institution. He has a CD, Wilford Brimley, with the Jeff Hamilton Trio. Please welcome Wilford Brimley, everybody. Wilford, it's always a pleasure to see your smiling face. How are you, buddy?
I'm okay. It's nice to see you. Isn't that funny? I'm glad to see him. He's a nice young man.
I'm young! Hey,
you still buy green bananas.
You got some extra business going on here. What's going on?
Well, I need it.
Why? Is it cold?
Speaking of cold, do you hang meat in here?
It's pretty cold in here. Yeah. Well, I like it.
You could hang an elk in here.
Well, it keeps my nipples perky. I like it.
Okay.
What's this you got here? You're wearing bling? What's going on? What's that?
That's an elk's tooth.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you an elk dentist of some kind?
I'm an elk killer.
Really? Hey, well, hold on. We don't know the whole story yet. Although I've got
that's
a feeling...
That's the whole story.
All right. Well, I see. Was this personal between you and the elk, or just something that you...
They're for us, so we eat it.
Right. You still living up there in, where is it, Wyoming you live?
That's where, yes,
sir. Yeah. Is it cold up there right now?
Not this cold.
How did you hook up with these fellas? What's this all about? You playing jazz now?
Well, they do.
Yeah. Well, what do? You're right there.
I know. I try to remember the words and stay in tune. These three chaps happen to be, in my opinion, the best jazz trio on this planet.
I see.
And I...
How did the elk feel about them? Is that...
Elk doesn't give...
Uh-oh. Okay. You turned them into an audience of elk haters right away. So, I didn't know you were interested in jazz. I had you down more as a kind of, you know, I don't know, classical music sort of a dude.
Well, music is a big part of my life. It has been all my life. And the music we did on this album is American music. It's been around for decades. Jerome Kern, Harold Arlen, Johnny Mercer, those guys, the Gershwin brothers, it's all on there. And it's...
All of these guys are on here?
Yeah, they're all on there.
Some of the guys you're talking about are no longer with us. You mean?
I know, but they're on that album. Oh,
really? So yeah.
Their legacy.
All right. Well, so what you're going to do is you're going to go off and then get your band ready. Here's things I thought I'd never say to Wilford Brimley. So we're going to take a break, and you're going to come back with the band. Is that what's going to happen, right? Are you on tour with these guys?
Am I on tour with them?
That's what I said.
Yeah, we got one stop, and it's right here.
That's it? We'll be right back with Wilford Brimley, the Jeff Hamilton Trio.
If you're watching Craig at home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at llstickets.com.
That don't happen too often in late night, Jeff.
This is one of them.
Here it comes. All right. My next guest, he was here earlier on. He's here performing Pick Yourself Up from the self-titled album Wilford Brimley with the Jeff Hamilton Trio. Please welcome Wilford Brimley with the Jeff Hamilton Trio, everybody.
Nothing's impossible, I have found. For when my chin is on the ground, I pick myself up, dust myself off, start over again. Don't lose your confidence if you slip. Be grateful for a pleasant trip and pick yourself up, dust yourself off, start all over again. Work like a soul inspired. Till the battle of the day is won. You might be sick and tired. You'll be a man, my son. Don't you remember the famous men who had to fall to rise again? They pick himself up, dust himself off, and start all over again. I have found, for when my chin is on the ground, I pick myself up, I dust myself off, start all over again. So don't lose your confidence if you slip. Be grateful for a pleasant trip and pick yourself up and dust yourself off, start over again. Work like a soul inspired until the battle of the day is done. You may be sick and tired, but you'll be a man, my son. And don't you remember the famous men who had to fall, rise again? They pick himself up, they dust himself off, start over again.
Wilford Brimley, the Jeff Hamilton Trio. Thank you, Mr. B. Good night.